Sashimi is packed with protein, making it a good food option for those on low carbohydrate diets or high protein diets. But how can you best eat it for weight loss? And what about sushi? Hi, I'm Dr. Brian Young, a naturopathic doctor in Toronto. Let's take a look at sushi and sashimi for weight loss. Sushi is differentiated from sashimi in that sushi is prepared with rice. It includes maki, which are the rolls and cones with rice, or nigiri, which is the fish placed on the little rice brick. Sashimi refers to the raw piece of seafood or meat sliced thinly with no rice added. Although both are frequently served together in Japanese cuisine, both sushi and sashimi are very different dishes with very different histories. The earliest forms of sushi originated in China and was introduced to Japan around 300 BC to 300 AD. Sashimi originated in Japan much later. When deciding what foods you should eat on your weight loss diet, limiting your intake of simple carbohydrates like sushi rice can be helpful to reduce spikes in insulin and reduce the amount of fat your body might store as a result. Meanwhile, increasing your dietary intake of protein can also help suppress appetite and reduce hunger. So if you enjoy sushi and sashimi, you might want to focus on sashimi while on your weight loss diet, since it's high in protein and does away with any simple carbs from sushi rice. In this video, we'll take a look at different types of common sashimi and compare their nutritional values and uses in a weight loss diet. Is sashimi healthy? There are two sides to this argument, but I'll briefly outline the main points. On one hand, sashimi provides some healthy omega-3 oils and fish protein. High intakes of both have been associated with some health benefits, like a reduced risk of heart disease or reduced inflammation. On the other hand, commercially available seafood tends to have higher levels of heavy metals and contaminants that are found in these types of top feeder fish. Sashimi is mostly composed of top feeder fish. These types of fishes eat other smaller fishes and tend to have higher concentrations of any contaminants that might be found in the water, since contamination concentrates up the food chain. High intakes of these heavy metals like methylmercury and other contaminants like plastic have been associated with an increased risk of a variety of health issues, like cancer and hormonal issues. So a diet high in sashimi may present as a double-edged sword and something you should keep in mind. Admittedly more so for your health than your weight. Types of sashimi. So let's say you want to eat sashimi for dinner. What types of sashimi might be the best? Let's first take a look at the fishes. Salmon, mackerel, butterfish, and fatty bluefin tuna are your fattiest cuts of fish. They also contain the most calories per 1 ounce sashimi piece, with salmon and mackerel leading the pack. Yellowfin tuna, skipjack tuna, sea bass, and halibut are your leaner cuts of fish, having barely any fat in comparison to the other cuts. Their protein density is quite high, having more protein than an egg per same amount of weight. The fattier cuts of fish also understandably have a much higher calorie density than the leaner cuts of fish, with one piece of salmon containing more calories than 2 pieces of halibut. For the rest of the non-fish seafood, most everything is quite low in calories and fat, while maintaining a good amount of protein. The only exception is sea urchin and roe, or fish eggs, both of which are some of the fattier and higher calorie non-fish sashimis. The cuttlefish like octopus and squid do have small amounts of carbohydrate, something to keep in mind if you're attempting a low carbohydrate diet. However, the amounts are small, amounting to around 1 gram of carbohydrate per cuttlefish slice. Soy sauce and some dipping sauces do have small amounts of carbohydrate or sugar. However, unless you're pouring these sauces all over your sashimi, the amounts dipped are somewhat insignificant. So, is sashimi good for weight loss? Let's go over some of its strengths and weaknesses. Strength: high protein content. Sashimi contains a high amount of protein without any significant carbohydrate, something that will help reduce hunger and suppress appetite. And because protein is also less efficiently converted into stored fat in our bodies, sashimi is a good option to increase your dietary intake of protein. Weakness: average appetite suppression. The magnitude of appetite suppression is very average, despite sashimi's high protein density and moderately high calorie density. It may have to do with the fact that sashimi is quite low in fat, which is a good thing for many people on low-fat diets, but loses out on fat's very potent appetite-suppressing effects. Even the higher-fat salmon or mackerel sashimis have less fat density than most cuts of beef or types of cheeses. Overall, sashimi can provide a good amount of protein to your weight loss diet. Due to its low fat density, however, I suggest that as a meal, you try to consume sashimi with something else, like a salad or some roasted vegetables, since it could otherwise take quite a few pieces to feel full. For example, an 8-ounce steak for dinner can provide a very good amount of fullness due to its high protein and fat content. But for many people, 8 1-ounce slices of sashimi sounds more like an appetizer. So it can be easy to overeat on sashimi if you're not careful. And it makes sense from a fullness perspective when people want to eat sushi or rice with their sashimi to feel full. Unfortunately, many dietary plans for weight loss limit rice and carbohydrate intake, and consuming too much rice with your sashimi might defeat the purpose of eating sashimi to help with weight loss in the first place. Yes, the high-protein sashimi is harder for your body to convert into fat than carbohydrates, but the rice you might be consuming alongside will be converted easily. So if you like sashimi, you can have it on your weight loss diet. Just make sure you control the amounts you eat, and have something else with it that will help you to feel fuller, like something with a good amount of soluble fiber and/or fat. Do you eat sashimi on your weight loss diet? And what types of sashimi do you like? Let me know about it in the comments down below. And if you found this video helpful, please leave me a like. As before, I'm Dr. Brian Young, bringing you weight loss info on this channel. Subscribe and hit the notification bell if you're interested in learning more, and share it with someone you know can use the help.